The following is a class from the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adilila Volume 1, Chapter 1, Text Number 16, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 9, 1975, in Hyderabad, India.
Dibbat Bindyaranya Kalpadrumadha श्रीमत् रत्नागार सिंहासनस्थो श्रीमत् राधा श्रील गोविंद देवो पृष्ठाली भी सेवमानो स्मरामि। तो डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ वृंदावन वृंदावन एंड राधा एंड कृष्ण situated there. The Vrindavan, Bon means forest, and Vrinda means tulsi. Mostly there are tulsi plants and other trees also, but all the trees are living desire trees, spiritual. They can serve Krishna in any way, desire. They have become trees by their voluntary desire. They are all spiritual beings. There is no force, but everyone has got a particular tendency to serve Krishna in a different way. So these trees and plants, they are also living beings. They are not ordinary living beings. But they have decided to serve Krishna by supplying fruits and flowers. They want that. Everyone has got his particular propensity. Someone is serving as the land there, someone is serving as the throne, someone is serving as the supplying agent of fruits and flowers, someone is engaged in his service as the gopis, confidential servitors, the cows, calves, everything. They are all different living entities. They are not made of this material thing, material body. Ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavitabhi stabhi eva nijarupataya kalabhi. They are all also expansion of Krishna's pleasure potential. In one sense, they are also Krishna. They are not different from Krishna. Shakti, Shaktimato, Aveda. The power and the powerful, they are not different, identical. Just like the sun and the sun sign. So, in the sun globe, there is heat and light, and the sun sign, there is heat and light. So far heat and light is concerned, they are one. Similarly, Krishna and Krishna's pleasure potency, Ananda Chinmaya, Alladini, it is already described. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikhiti Alladini Shakti Asma. So, whatever description is there of Vrindavan, that is expansion of Krishna's pleasure potential. They are not different. Therefore, in the beginning, it is said, Dibbad, shining, or divine, transcendent. So we should not consider Vrindavan as ordinary forest. Here, we have got Vrindavan on this planet, that is also not ordinary forest. They were exactly the same Vrindavan as it is Goloka Vrindavan. There is no difference. Therefore, Nartam Das Thakur says that Vishaya Chariya Kave Shuddha Have Mon Kave Hama He Rava Sri Vrindavan. Vishaya Chariya. Our present position is that we are materially diseased. So we have to become free from the material disease. Material disease means sense gratification. And the most formidable disease is sex. This is called material disease. So Vishaya Chariya, we have to become free from the contamination of Vishaya, material enjoyment. This is the statement of Narottam Das Thakur. Vishaya Chariya Kave Shuddha Have Mon Kave Hama He Rava Sri Vrindavan. When my mind will be cleansed of all material desires, then I shall be able to see what is Vrindavan. It is very difficult to see Vrindavan with material desires. Bhakti means the first qualification is to become free from all material desires. Sarvapadhi-vininmuktam. Sarvapadhi-vininmuktam tat-paratena-nirmalam. Rishikena-rishikesa-sevanam-bhakti-ruchyat. Anna-vilasita-sunnam. Jnana-karmadana-britam. Anukullena-krishnanu-silanam-bhakti-ruchyat. You know all these definition of bhakti given in our Nectar of Devotion. So spiritual life means free from material desires. And material desires mean just to hanker after sense gratification. This is materialism. When we have no more desire for sense gratification, then we should think that we are on the spiritual platform. So, this description of Vrindavan is spiritually described. Therefore, in the beginning, the word is used, Dibyat. Dibyat means divine. Krishna says, Janma karma me dibbam. This is not ordinary material. The desire tree also described in the Brahma Sanghita. Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalpa vrikha. The same kalpa vrikha. Lakhabrite sibu suravi ravipalayantam. Lakshmi sahasra sata samrama sevamanam. This Lakshmi sahasra sata sevamanam is described here as prasthalivi sevamanam. Prastha alivi. Prastha means very dear and oli means gopis, associates of Radha. Friends. So they are all Lakshmis, goddess of fortune. Lakshmi, you have heard the name Lakshmi. Lakshmi Narayan, associates of Narayan. Krishna is Narayan. So all these gopis, their expansion of Srimati Radharani, the original Lakshmi. This is spiritual world. It is not impersonal, neither nirakar, formless. Everything form, but that form is different from this form. That form is Satchit Ananda form, eternal, full of bliss, full of knowledge. This is not this material form. When we speak of formless, that means without any material form. Formless does not mean Krishna and his expansion, that formless. They are not of material form, of prakriti. Not material. Here everything is prakriti. It is not neither eternal, nor blissful, nor full of knowledge. It is temporary, full of ignorance, and always miserable. This form. We can understand it. But that is just opposite. This form is temporary. Everyone knows this form will be finished. Antabhattui me deha, Krishna says, this body is antabhat. Antabhat means it will be finished. It grew at a certain depth, and it will increase, it will stay, then it will dwindle, then it will produce some byproducts and then vanish. This is called Sarvika, six kinds of changes of the material body. Of the spiritual body, there is no such change. That is the difference between spiritual body and material body. Therefore, it is called Sat. Sat means eternal. There is no change. Just like Krishna, his body is Satchitananda. Therefore, he never grows old. He'll never find a picture of Krishna that he has grown old. No. There is no change. Advaita Achyutaya Anadi Anantarupam Adyam Purana Purusham. Purana Purusham means the oldest person. Mr. Krishna is the origin of everything. Sometimes they consider, because God is very old, therefore he must have big beard, and that is imagination. Here you find the real description of God. Pura Advaita Achyuta Anadi Anantarupam Adyam, original, Purana Purusham, the oldest of all, Navajovanancha, but his bodily feature is just like a fresh young man. That is Krishna. He'll never find Krishna. Krishna, when he was in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he was great grandfather. But he'll find a young boy. That is Krishna. So that is eternal. Now, our body is not Sat. Krishna's body is Sat, Chit Ananda. Our this material body, Asat. And because we have got Asat means temporary, that will not exist. And because we have accepted this material body, therefore we are full of anxiety. Ultimately, what is our anxiety? We are always trying to, this is called struggle for existence, survival of the fittest. So we are trying to become the fittest, to exist. But that is not possible in this body. That is not possible, because it is asat, it is not sat. And because the struggle is that we want to exist in this body, therefore there is anxiety. असद गृहात सदा समुद्विग्न धियाम असद गृहात द शास्त्र से तो वी आर ऑलवेज फुल ऑफ एंग्जाइटीज व्हाई नो असद ग्रहा वी हैव एक्सेप्टेड दिस बॉडी विच विल नॉट एग्जिस्ट असद ग्रहा दीज आर फैक्ट्स स्टडी शास्त्र इन दैट वे Why we are full of anxiety? Because we have accepted this body. So our main business is how to get out of this entanglement of this temporary body. The people are not very seriously thinking, neither they have got sufficient knowledge how the temporary body is obtained, how it is changed, another temporary body, and there are 8,400,000 different forms of body, and we are changing one after another. Why this disease? If I am, my position is, as I understand from Bhagavad Gita, na hannate hannamane sarire. I am not destroyed after the destruction of this body. Why I am in this position? That I have to change my body. Tatha dehantara prapti. This is intelligence. When you come to this intelligence, then athada brahma jignasa. Then the inquiry about spiritual life begins. But unfortunately, we are in such a civilization that we have no time to think of this great dangerous position of changing body one after another, and we have accepted it, there is no remedy, we have to change or die for good. These theories, this ignorance is going on, and Krishna consciousness movement is the only movement which is trying to educate man to this standard of knowledge, that he may at least think that I am not this body. As I understand from the shastras, I am within the body. So how I can become free of this material body? That is our real problem. Janma mitya jarabhyadhi dukkha dosanu darsana. So if we take it very seriously, then we become gradually advanced and eligible or fit candidate to go into the spiritual world, Dibbad Bindyaranna Kalvudrumada. We can go there. That is what. Be serious. Don't be misled by the allurement of Maya. Remain strong. And then in this life, you'll be able to become fit candidate to go back to home, back to Godhead. Dibbad Bindyaranna Kalvudrumada. He will also be one of the associates of Krishna as you desire. Krishna will give you the opportunity to serve him as you desire. If you want to serve him as gopi, you'll get that position. If you want to serve him as coward's boyfriend, you'll get that opportunity. If you want to serve Krishna, following the footsteps of Mother Yashoda, accepting Krishna as your son, you'll get it. Accepting Krishna as your son, Nanda Maharaj, following. We have to follow their principle. Not that I shall become Nanda Maharaj, or I shall become Yashoda. No, that is Mayava. You have to follow how they are loving Krishna. You have to learn that. Then you will get the chance of Krishna's association. Dibbad Bindyaranna Kalvudrumada. Prasthali Visebhumanus Maram. The Gaudiya Vaishnav generally, following the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they aspire to become one of the assistants of the gopis. There are others also who like to be the assistants of the cowherd boy. So our Goswami is Rupa Goswami, Sirup Sanatana Vattaraguna, they were all the assistants of the gopis. Gopi bhava rasamrita abhilahari kallolo magnon moho bande rupa sanatana ragujigo sri jiva gopalako. These six Goswamis, Rupa Sanatana Bhattaraguna, Srijiv Gopal Bhattadas Raguna, they are all very, very big men, not ordinary men. Ministers, jamindars, learned scholars, they are not ordinary men. And then gave up everything. Tattva turnamasi samandalapati saning sada tuchava. Just like Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, they were ministers in the government of Hussain Shah. Raghunath Das Goswami was the only son of his father and uncle, very, very big jamindar, landholder, 12 lakhs of rupees income. 500 years, 12 lakhs, 12 crores now. He was so rich man. Similarly, Gopal Bhatta Goswami, Srila Jiva Goswami, they are very, very learned. Jiva Goswami was the nephew of Rupa Goswami, very learned scholar. So either scholar, rich man, big politician, all of them gave up their material occupational duty and joined Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his Sankirtan movement. So they are always absorbed in the gopis' activities, always thinking. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was always thinking of Srimati Radharani's activities, and the Goswamis, they are also thinking of the gopis' activities. Gopis' activities mean to assist Srimati Radharani, how to serve Krishna. Prasthali bhi, seva mano, they are always ready. So in this way, there is the description of the spiritual world. You just have a glimpse of the spiritual world. How they are perpetually enjoying blissful life with full knowledge. That is described here. Dibbad-vindhyaranya-kalpa-dramadha Srimad-ratnagara-singhasana-stho. They are the singhasana, the throne. That is also spiritual. That is not material. Everything is spiritual. Simply, in different capacity, they are serving. There the water is also spiritual. So this spiritual realization, if we get the opportunity, fortunate enough, then naturally we shall aspire to enter into the spiritual world. Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, Krishnena saṃsāra kara chhāri anācha. If you want to enter into this association of spiritual kingdom, then practice here family of Krishna. Just like here, we are trying to be family members of Krishna. Here Krishna is sitting, Radha Madhava is sitting on the throne. He is the enjoyer. And we are trying to serve him so that he may very nicely enjoy. This is called Krishna family. Center Krishna. Just like in ordinary family, the head man is there and he is the chief man and all other, his wife, children, servants and other friends, associates, even animals, cats, dogs, cows, everyone is serving the central point, master. Similarly, our Krishna family means Krishna is the master and he is the supreme enjoyer. Bhoktaram jagatavasam sarvalokamaheswaram. And if we understand this point, that Krishna is the center, he is the enjoyer, and we are meant for serving him for his enjoyment, that is Krishna consciousness. So we have to, according to the shastric injunction, according to the spiritual master instruction, everywhere we have to organize this Krishna family. So Krishna family does not mean starvation. Krishna family means to enjoy, simply. Simply minus this material contamination. Chari anacha. Anacha means not proper behavior. Proper behavior means to remain always pious. And improper behavior means to become impious, sinful. If you become sinful, then you cannot enter into the family of Krishna. That is not possible. Krishna is described in the Bhagavad Gita by Arjuna, Parabrahma Param Dhamma Pavitram Paramam Bhava. Pavitra. Pavitra means pure, completely pure, without any material contamination. So if you want to enter into Krishna's family, then you have to become also completely pure. Otherwise there is no chance. Completely pure. Of all material contamination, that can be done when we give up our designation. That can be done. If I think I am American, I am Indian, I am Brahman, I am Kshatriya, I am Vaishya, I am white, I am black, these are upadhi, designation. And if we think like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that I am not this, I am not a Brahman, I am not a Kshatriya, I am not a Vaishya, I am not a Shudra, I am not a Brahmachari, I am not this, not this, then what you are? Gopi bhattu padakamalyo dasu dasanu. I am simply servant of the servant of Krishna. That is Sarvapadi Vinimukta. Then he will remain pure. And as soon as we think in the bodily concept of life, then he will remain impure. This is the process. How to give up this bodily concept of life? That is called Sarvapadi Vinimukta. In this way, in one life, we may practice how to become free from this material contamination and execute devotional service as it is prescribed in the Shastra and by the instruction of spiritual master. If we keep ourselves pure without material contamination, then we become fit to enter into the family of Krishna. This is the process. Thank you very much.